Fallout 3 Strategy Guide for Rebel Link Walkthroughs, and I'm your host, Rebel Link. Alright, so here we are at Megaton. Now before we go in, and actually we're going to do something else before we go in, I wanted to touch base on money and armor / clothing real quick. Figured we talked about perks and skills already, might as well talk about that. So with money, it's not going to be too much of an issue. What you want to do is, as you're going through the level, even while you're in Rivet City, I guess I should have mentioned that in Rivet City, but pick up anything you find that when you hover over it, it's not red. Because if you pick up something that's red, then it's stealing. And if you don't want bad karma or, you know, people to chase you, then, you know, stay away from that. Pick up anything you find, because everything, pretty much everything that you can pick up has a value to it. As long as it's not too heavy, take it with you, and then go to your bartering stores or supply stores, and or you'll see occasionally out in the wasteland just these bartering people with these, you know, things attached to the cows and whatnot. But anyways, go up to them, give them everything you can, and you know, that way you can make a little money on the side to buy the things you want and repair some of the stuff you need while your skills are still low. The other thing is, eventually, look at all your weapon inventory. Take a close look at what you're not using. For example, I don't use the 10mm bullets, ammo, excuse me. And so the 10mm bullets themselves, you're going to use them for this gun we're showing here, and also for the submachine gun. I don't use that very much. So anytime I find the ammo, you're going to find hordes of it everywhere. Tons and tons of ammo of that 10mm. Well, guess what? It's worth a decent amount of money. And literally, as I go on just one mission, come back, and I'll wipe out, like, you know, the supply person or barter person when I have, like, $700. I'll wipe them out and still have ammo. So that's usually a good way for you to, if you don't want to pick up, like, leaf blowers or, you know, whatever you find out there in the wasteland. Ammo has no weight to it, and has tons of value because you find tons of it everywhere. So that's an easy way to make money. So definitely do that. Alright, armor and clothing. Now what you're going to start off with is like the vault suit. And it has some redeeming qualities. If I'm not mistaken, you have like +5 science and +5 something else. But it does not protect you very much. So you definitely want to get rid of it as well as you can, or as fast as you can. And the supply, once you go to Maria Brown, who's in Megaton, go up to her and talk to her, and she's going to give you a modified armor suit, which is going to give you, I believe it's like 10 or 12 protection, damage resistance, and it's going to give you +5 small guns, and +5, I can't think of it on top of my head, but it's well worth wearing for the first part of this game. Now, once you go into the wasteland, if you run into raiders, typically, you know, that's pretty good armor to use, because that'll take you up to 15 or 16 damage resistance. But really, the ones you want to take advantage of, especially once you get your repair up, start collecting. Anytime you run into the Talon mercenaries, take their armor, because if your repair is 100, you can actually get that armor all the way up to 28. Maria here in Megaton will sometimes sell combat armor. That one's pretty good because that actually gets up to 32 damage resistance. And every now and then you'll run into somebody who has metal armor that actually gets up to 36. That's probably the best non-special, you know, armor that they give you, or non power armor that you'll find. Also, once you do a Riley's Ranger mission, which is that signal, that mission can be picked up by when you go get the Declaration of Independence from that historical collector in Rivet City. He's going to tell you to go get the Declaration of Independence. Once you go to that building, you're going to pick up the Riley Ranger signal, and it starts a mission if you decide to turn that, you know, signal on. Anyways, if you beat that one, and I would probably advise wait till you're probably like 10 to 12 level, because that level is actually, Riley's Rangers level is actually pretty hard, because you're in a building, and all it is all super mutants, and they come at you 2, 3, 4 at a time, and at the end of it, you know, there's like 8 or 9 at a time. So anyways, she'll give you a choice of either getting a really neat Gatling gun, can't remember what the name of it's called, but it has pretty good damage, so if you're going for the big explosives or the big weapons, and you know, feel free to knock yourself out and get that. But the other option she'll give you is armor, and that actually goes up to 39 damage resistance. So that's a neat one to pick up if you haven't learned the power armor, if you haven't gone through the power armor training yet. And if you don't know what power armor is, then there's just Google it, or not Google it, but YouTube it. And she believes me, there's trillions of videos out there for them. Now, the best power armor, once you get that skill, is obviously the T51B. That gives you up to 50. The other one that's out there that's really good is Telsa armor, which is also a power armor. And that gives you 45, but more importantly, it gives you plus 10 on your energy weapons. So if you are at 85 on energy weapons, there you'll be 95. And so it's a pretty good one to have. Oh, and quick note on the skill book magazines I mentioned earlier in my earlier videos. There's not 10 to 15 as I thought. There's actually 25 of them all over. 25 of each skill all over Wasteland. So if you're really ambitious, you know, put your skills up to 75 and find all the magazines. But I think if you go to 85 or 90 on the skills, stop there and just find the magazines as you go along, you'll be just fine. Alright, so let's unpause and get into Megaton. Well, before we get into Megaton, I'm going to show you something that's pretty neat that you don't really have to work too hard for. But follow where I'm going, and you will run into some mole rats hanging out. I already went through this area and killed them off. And there's actually this hidden cache of weapons, and that's over here. And you're gonna know to find it. You're gonna be looking for three like small trees. Here it is, right here. Really easy to find. And then go up to the rock, and it'll. I guess there's like a hidden pocket or some sorts. But anyways, you get a sniper rifle right off the bat of the game, and you also get a stealth boy, which you don't want to use that. We're gonna save it when we go get Charon. So don't use it just then. Alright, now we're in Megaton. You are, hopefully you have your explosive skill to 25. And we're going to go up to the bomb and defuse it. Now first, before you actually get to this, you have to talk to Lucas Sims, who's the black guy with the cowboy outfit. And you have to kind of get his permission to defuse a bomb. And all you got to do is ask him, let him know you'll do it. So what happens is when you defuse it, they give you a home. They're impressed with your defusing skills, and you get a home. Now, if you blow it up, you want to go visit the guy in Maury's bar, and he'll want you to blow it up, and then go ahead and do that, and you'll get a nice, really nice pad and tenpenny towers. But you're gonna get tons of not really good karma, so be careful, there's consequences with it. So here's our home, and also the end of part 2 video of I'm the Bomb. In part 3, we're going to talk about this house in detail.